Hello, this is John Schaap and welcome to this video in the updated 2021 version of the iOS 8 video series. In this video, I'm going to show you how to generate, upload and use server certificates for the captive portal on the controller cluster members and also on ClearPass. The network is still the same as in all the other videos and we will reuse the guest network that was created in part 6 of this video series. You need to create server certificates both for the controllers and also for ClearPass when you do not want to get any certificates warnings when your guest users connect to the wireless LAN. The same server certificate is used on all three controllers in the cluster. The server certificates need to be signed by a public root CA, and in this case I will use Let's Encrypt as CA, but any public root CA can be used. You also need to install the Let's Encrypt ISRG root X1 certificate and the Let's Encrypt R3 certificate to the trust list of ClearPass. The certificates used in this example are only valid for 3 months, so for test perfect, but not so for production networks, as you have to renew every 3 months. You can see in this slide how controller-initiated guest redirect works. A guest Wi-Fi user connects to the guest network and is placed in a user role where he is redirected to a page on ClearPass. On most mobile devices, a captive network assistant will launch a mini browser and show you this page. The Wi-Fi user creates an account on this page and that triggers a login action on the mini browser. The browser will send a post message to the controller and the controller processes that login and initiates a radius access request. User is allowed on the network if this login is successful. This means that the web browser has to set up both a HTTPS session to ClearPass and also to the controller. So that is why you need to install valid service certificates to both. So here we see the certificate for the controller. What is very important is the common name. So that's captiveportal-login.fqdn. That needs to match on the controller. The other one is for ClearPass, and that's ClearPass.fqdn. And that one needs to be resolvable via DNS. And this is the chain of trust of Let's Encrypt. So on top you see the ISRG root X1, that's the root CA. And then the intermediate is called R3. Both of them need to be added to ClearPass. You need to install a Linux PC, and I'm using Ubuntu for that. An Apache 2 web server also needs to run on this PC, and port 80 HTTP should be open. So check that the web server is reachable, as Let's Encrypt needs to connect to it to verify before a certificate is issued. You also need to have a valid domain name for this to work, because Let's Encrypt offers domain validation DV certificates. You also need to install Certbot and OpenSSL on this Linux PC. So two SSH sessions open to the same server, and then we are going to issue this command, sudo certbot cert only. Very important, check the domain, it needs to be captiveportal-login and then the FQDN. And this will start the process. So then we go to the second session, and we go to this directory, and we see that it is still empty. And we wait for this one to finish. So it is finished now, and you have to create a file containing this data. So you copy it from here to the other screen. And I'm using printf and then %s. And then the data that you're going to put in the file, and copy the file name from the other screen. That's the file name. And this file needs to be available for Let's Encrypt to check on your web server. So it's not allowed, so I have to change with sudo. And do it one more time. Copy it from here. And now it succeeds. And if you do an ls, you see that that file is there with that file name. So you can now hit enter to continue on this screen, and that will initiate the contact with Let's Encrypt, and then Let's Encrypt checks the file and generates the certificates and stores them. You can see that here, successfully received certificates. And then we're going to do the other certificate. So this is clearpass.fqdn, Same principle as with the first certificate. So here's the file data. So copy it again to the other screen and put it into the file with this name. Like this. And now we have two files there with two different file names, of course. And here are the certificates, so it says successfully received certificates. And you can find them here at this location. So let's go there. See what's there. So there's now two directories, captiveportallogin.fqdn and clearpass.fqdn. Let's go in there and see what's there. So you will see the certificate itself, the chain, the full chain, and the private key. For the controllers, you need to create a PFX file, and that's what we use OpenSSL for. So with this command, we take the output is the PFX file, and we take the private key and the certificate and the chain and put it into this PFX file. So it's one file containing everything. You need to set a password on it. That's what I do here. And now we have another file in the directory with the extension PFX, and that one can be imported into the controller. You do not need to do this for ClearPass. And we have to change the permissions so that others besides the root can read this file and download it. So now you see it can be done. Then we go to the other directory. So this is the ClearPass certificate. And as I said before, we can just download the cert and the private key and put it into ClearPass. So that's what we're going to do now. So we go to ClearPass. The first thing we're going to do is put those two certificates in the trust list. So you click add. You select the file. So the first one is the ISO root and the Let's Encrypt. Those two certificates need to be added. And you select others, add certificate, and then one more time for the other one. So this adds the in the root CA Let's Encrypt and the intermediate CA to the trust list of ClearPass. You see them here, and they need to be enabled. Then we go to the certificate store and we're going to add a HTTPS RSA server certificate. You click import certificate. It is a server certificate. It's HTTPS RSA. And we're going to upload certificate and private key as separate files. So that's why you don't need to do the PFX in this case for ClearPass. So you select the certificate and you select the private key. And the password that you've set during the creation of the certificate. And then you input it and you see now that the certificate with the common name clearpass.fqdn is installed and it's issued by Let's Encrypt. And this is the intermediate CA and the root CA is in the trust list. So you're all set over here. Now we go to the guest part and we go to the self-registration portal, advanced editor. And one thing that you need to change here is the address. That address needs to be the common name of the certificate that we have issued, and that's captiveportal-login.fqdn. That's the only thing we need to change. This is the same portal that we have used in the previous video for guest access. So it's just a standard web portal self-registration page on ClearPass. And this needs to be set correctly. If you now do launch login, you see that it launches the login page. It's still not valid, but this looks good. So it's the root CA, let's encrypt the R3 and the ClearPass certificate. The reason why the browser says it's not valid is because it points to an IP address and it should point to the common name. So if you change that to ClearPass and then the FQDN and refresh, you see that the warning is gone. And now everything is in order. So this is a valid certificate for the browser. Then it's time to upload the certificate to the controllers. So we do that at EMEA level so that it flows to all three controllers below it. You give that a name, you browse for that PFX file that we have created. You have to give the password that you installed when you created the PFX file. Select the right format and, very important, the right type. Submit. And now you see that the certificate is there. Deploy it. Check it out. Make sure that the issued to is correctly set. That needs to match what we just previously configured on ClearPass guest. Needs to exactly match that. And then we go to profiles on the individual controller. So you go to system and then the web server configuration and you change the captive portal certificate to the certificate that we just uploaded. And you have to do this 3 times for all three controllers. So it's the same server certificate for all three controllers. So this is the last one. Okay, done. Deploy the changes. And then we can check in the individual controllers the show web server profile. And you should see the captive portal certificate with the right name. This is a different name that you saw me doing previously. The videos has been recorded in different sessions. So I've used CP minus login as a name before. So that's the same as you see here. So second controller. The right certificate, and if you do show data path FQDN, you have to check if the right FQDN entry is there, captive portal minus login, that's good. And the same for controller number 3, needs to be the same on all three controllers. That's good. And the FQDN, also good. So now let's have a look on a web browser what happens when you connect to the guest network and how the redirection is working. In this example, I disabled the captive network assistant so that I can use a normal browser with tracing. So here it tries to connect to www.hpe.com, but you will see that that is being intercepted by the controller and you get a temporarily moved message back where it is redirecting the user to the page on ClearPass. User now fills in its details on this web page, on this self-registration page. And after he is done, you will see that the receipt is being presented. And then the next action will happen. And that's the post message to the controller. And that's this one. So you will see that the address has changed now. It is going to captive portal minus login.myfqdn. And it's posting that message on the controller, which initiates the radius access request and logging the user in. After that, the user can just browse anything. That brings us to the end of this video. So let's recap what we have done. We have used an Ubuntu PC to install an Apache 2 web server, OpenSSL and Certbot to create certificate requests to be signed by Let's Encrypt and install these server certificates on the controllers and ClearPass to create a guest network where users are not experiencing certificate errors because of the default untrusted self-signed certificates that are used. Please like, subscribe, and let me know in the comments what you think. Bye for now.